it continues
I'll
to be.
I'll ask you, what will happen when we just took a step ahead and go into virtual reality?
Let's talk about the digital theater era, or at least that's what we were forced into of late. Lots of digital shows, live shows, that had to take the digital stage in comparison to physically holding shows. I know artists were impacted to such a large extent. That magic element of interaction, doing it live in front of a crowd, is always missing. What's it like, according to you, this comparison of digital world versus live theater shows?
Well, like all others, diehard theater people, I said no. And this is only second best, and we don't want to go there. In fact, we have very, very consciously said no to streaming of plays out of Rangashankara at one point of time, or recording them while they are still running. I can understand theater, because it is such a transient art. It makes good sense to record a play very well, and after the play is closed, it's good archival material, it's good historical material. I think the pandemic made everybody swallow humble pie, yeah? And Rangashankara and all of us at Rangashankara quickly, very, very quickly realized that this is a matter of, also a matter of survival, and a matter of not being foolish, not being an ostrich. You don't kind of hide your head in the sand and say the problem doesn't exist. It was knocking at our door. It had shut our doors. So how do we keep the spirit of our actors alive? Actors suddenly didn't know what to do. So it was the job of an institution to actually, you know, sum up all its courage and think on its feet that, yes, I'm not going to be an ostrich. I'm going to take this as a challenge. My job is to keep the spirit of my kabila, my community, alive. So what can I do? So we contacted, for World Theatre Day, we recorded solo performances, 5-minute pieces, monologues by a bunch of around 20 actors. Put that up on YouTube. Then we have very beautiful storytelling sessions here at Rangashankara called Little Cloud. So we said that is a program that can be actually translated very quickly into the medium. And so we contacted our actor friends around the country and said, come on guys, tell a story. That was the eureka moment for us, when we realized that we cannot be in denial of technology. And technology has to be used. Of course, it cannot replace the live human being, but it is good. It's good to take the story further away.
Right. Yeah. You know, while people constantly talk about what is going to happen with OTT versus cinema world, and whether the clash has already begun, does it make sense for people to go buy a movie ticket to watch a movie? I feel theater owns its own space because it is live interaction. So irrespective of what the platform, OTT or movie halls, the theater space is unparalleled to any, and it continues
I'll
to be.
I'll ask you, what will happen when we just took a step ahead and go into virtual reality? We are looking at, it has already come. The thought has come. So then it's only a matter of time before people will sell you the view from this seat and then the view from this seat. Yeah?
So in a way, we have, I guess that was a trailer for us to get used to just doing things differently.
Yeah, yeah. To actually step out of the box, because we are traditional, we are a little archaic. Yes, it is an old art. Yes, it will survive. It has survived. If the first theatre performer was a Stone Age man talking about the hunt around a fire and describing the hunt of the day, then embellishing it, nothing has changed. We're still telling stories about the hunt. Yeah? So the human element, as long as that is alive, I think theatre has no death.